Hello and welcome back to Tinker Talks Guns. This time it's time for Poor Impulse Control Theater, where I show you why I should not be unsupervised in my workshop. So, I keep seeing 32 rimfire revolvers at very reasonable prices, but 32 rimfire is no longer made. Researching this, I discovered that some people had special cartridges made that accepted ramset rimfire blanks for nail guns and loaded the ramset blanks into these cartridges and then put a ball on the other end so they could fire their 32 rimfires. And this seemed interesting, not interesting enough for me to bother, but it sparked a thought. If it'll work for a rimfire cartridge, maybe it'll work for something else. So we're going to show you the something else. But let's go to the tabletop and have a look. So here before you lies the result of my poor impulse control. The postmodern muzzle loader, complete with antler grips, accessory tools, also with matching antler, and 32 caliber plated buckshot. So what this is I had a section of 0.312 inch barrel from an old Maison Nagant, and I created a firearm. So it's on the safety notch. You rotate this 90 degrees, you can pop open the barrel, where there is a chamber for a 22 caliber ramset blank. These are number 3 blanks, and they seem to produce ballistics comparable to Smith & Wesson, 32 Smith & Wesson long. You put a ball in the muzzle, ram it in with the ramrod, which is cupped on the end to cover the ball and keep it centered. Ram it in and insert the ramset blank, and then you can cock and fire the gun. The sight, the rear sight, is actually cut into the top of the hammer, and there is a small front sight. The trigger is of the sheathed type, so when the gun is uncocked, the trigger is pretty much hidden. When you bring it to safety cock, the trigger pops out and stays popped out when you bring it to full cock. Pops out even a little more. And then you just pull the trigger and it fires. I'm not going to dry fire it because it's rim fire. So this is constructed of 10/18 plate for the sides, and some 5160 spring steel for the internals, a couple of custom-made screws holding everything together, and the box came from Goodwill, a secondhand store, paid about $3.50 for it, and then I did all the lining in green felt, set up to hold all the accessories, including this screwdriver, very useful. And all of the antler is cut from the same piece. And in a firing grip, the gun sits quite low in your hand. So you've just got room to see the sights over the top of your hand. I guess that gives you faster follow-up shots. Of course it doesn't. So, let's have a look at what we've got going on here. This is held together by two screws, and this, which is another screw, but it doesn't come out easily. So what we do, first things first, screwdriver porn with a custom screwdriver. The best. All right. Unscrew this screw, unscrew the hinge screw that the barrel tilts on. And then you can turn this lever, remove the barrel, and then unscrew this, the locking piece, which as you can see is got flat spots so that you can disengage or engage the lock, turn it this way, barrel can't open, turn it this way, and it can. Having those screws out, we can remove the side plate and examine the innards, which as you can see are extremely simple. There's a coil spring with a push rod, the hammer, trigger, which incorporates the sear, and there is a floating firing pin, or actually a not so floating firing pin. But the firing pin does rebound. So, your safety notch, can't drive forward, full cock, which is deliberately a bit long in the trigger pull, just for safety, because there's no other safeties on the gun. So basically, the gun has four moving parts, if you count the spring plunger and the firing pin as separate moving parts. So, very simple. And these bits are soldered together. And the rest is just 1/4 inch 5160 spring steel. Anyway, very simple. Very easy to disassemble, very easy to put back together. Putting it back together. I always start with this one, I don't know why. Okay. And then the large screw. Premium screwdriver horn. And then the barrel. Looks like I'll have to jiggle this a bit. There we go. So, once that's locked down, put in the hinge pin, and we are fully reassembled. So, there you have it. So, the postmodern muzzle loader. The most obvious question is, why? And the only real answer is, why not? It was fun, it was interesting, and it actually works. Who knew? So, and sometimes that's all the excuse you need. And it's a good project, and it's an interesting conversation piece. Anyway, if you like the video, hit like and subscribe. Click the notification if you want to be notified when new videos come out. And if you wish to give me more material support, please consider clicking the link in the description to my Patreon and supporting me there. Anyway, I hope this finds you well. Stay safe, take care, and we'll talk to you again real soon.